And the parents of the young man, child who died has come forward to say, he's our child. And he died from drowning. Not sponsored by anybody. Because don't forget, security is in the hands of the federal government, so I don't have to get involved. But they came forward on their own with that statement. Mm. Would you therefore ask me to prosecute security men who did not even shoot? And when this thing was happening, I was in Abuja. And I got a text. The security men are killing people in Bundu. I panicked. And I called the security. I called the SSG. I called the security men. And they said nothing like that happened. They went there to mark houses and enumerate the number of houses and people living there so that they can be paid compensation. Instead of allowing them, some of them mobilized youths from outside Bundu to that place and tried to frustrate them. And they literally quietly withdrew. Mm. Two is that you are also not correct with your figures. One third of Port Harcourt in Bundu, you know how small Bundu is?
Stop the exchange now. We didn't answer the question.
No, but even if it's waterfront, one third of Port Harcourt in the waterfront, you can't be right. You are not right. You know what it is to have one third of Port Harcourt in the waterfront? In Shanks? Certainly not. You're not correct. And I challenge you to that information. I'll get the government to pay your transportation to Port Harcourt. Let's go with you to physically camp. Then I give the challenge I gave to United Nations UN Habitat. I challenge you to come and live at Bundu Waterside for 3 months and I will not demolish Bundu Waterside. For 3 months and I will not demolish Bundu Waterside. There is mosquito.
Please, we are not going to have a protest meeting here. Let the governor finish, please.
I invite you to come. I will take you there. If you stay for 3 months, I will not demolish you. Then, on the issue of diaspora, just like they are here studying, they are not at school studying the University of Kumbaka. All of them are private students at college. Whenever we want to hire anybody, we will go and publicize it. If you're successful, we will take you. I didn't say Nigerians love corruption. I said Nigerians don't dislike corruption. You know, there are two things. I didn't say Nigerians love corruption. But we don't dislike it. We dislike it, we will fight it. And I give the example of the father. Okay, if I finish the deal without a house, without a car, I will have friends.
So what do you think?
They will ask, what were you doing there?
So what do you
think? Is it a lie, Nigerians?
No.
So, why are you asking me who is challenging me that I think Nigerians don't dislike corruption? The moment you come out, if I come out as governor, I don't have a Rolls Royce, nobody will invite me to meet him. If I come to function, I will rapidly tell this joke in Nigeria that once you leave office, you are an ex-governor. After some time, you're a former governor. After some time, you're a one-time... Now, those who are ex-governors are those who have lessons and all that. Yes, let's say the ex-governor or former governor of the party. But if you didn't come up with anything, in 1 week, you go to one-time governor. So whoever says Nigerians... I didn't say Nigerians love corruption. I say we don't dislike corruption. Because we have fought corruption with all our minds. Then, I have never criticized my former boss. Don't forget I was a speaker in the city. Never. I rather believe that he allowed the press to paint him too black. Too black. True, when I was speaking, I told you that 150 megawatts from Omok was commissioned in his regime. Didn't I say that?
Yes.
When they wrote 130 that the president will commission, I said no, out of the 130, 30 was Odili's. The 100 is what I'm going to commission, which is what I completed. Right? And then I talked about 75 megawatts that I'm working on, and the 180 megawatts. Actually, even the 100 I'm commissioning was started by Dr. Odili, and I completed it. Not clap yet. The 100 was started by him and completed it. The 75 was started by him and completed it. The only new project in the power sector that I'm doing is the 180 megawatts that is being done by Saipem and Alstom of France. Saipem is an Italian company based in Nigeria, and Alstom is a French company also based in Nigeria. So, I'm not among those. He did quite a number of things. Roads, he did some roads. They renovated schools, but I chose to rebuild new schools completely. He did one or two, he did quite a lot of things. I'm not among those who did anything. But you see, in Nigeria, if you don't fight the press back when people begin to feed them with information, then you will live highly vilified. That's why if you call me a thief today, I will fight you with the last bite of blood I have. I said militancy is an ideology. I don't want to limit it to just an idea. Because it comes with objectives and aims. And it people say, banger. To do what? To frustrate those who oppress us. If this was a banger, we'll be kidnapping foreigners when they come. Because the consequence of kidnapping the foreigner is that investors will no longer come in. What does that happen? Businesses will fly out. What happens after that? Employment, unemployment will quickly. What follows after unemployment? Poverty. What follows poverty? Death. So, who is saying, who are those militants? Who's going to be a militant here? That saying that he's fighting for Niger Delta life. These are people that poverty has visited everybody in Nigeria and Niger Delta, that have started to leverage on that inability of government to visit us with justice, to make their own money from their own pocket and everything. Then you talked about sharing the money. No, I'm not sharing the money. I don't believe in sharing the money. If I start sharing, you see it in me. The truth is that we saved the 100 billion naira in the banks then. Are you aware that they took our oil wells? Aquaman took our oil wells, whatever means they took our oil wells, I don't know, but you know Nigeria, they've taken our oil wells, so we're caught. Within that period that they took our oil wells, we didn't have enough money, so we quickly went to our savings. This savings is independent of the sovereign wealth fund that we're saving. That one is 21 billion. This savings is 100. So we stepped into that savings and we're using it to complete our projects. That's why what you saw there was 37 billion remaining out of the 100 billion. So I'm not sharing the money. Money is
still
and if you say that my business is windy, no, I see the firebrand. I got black, white, and most people don't like it in Nigeria. In fact, there is an attempt, people say they won't allow you to come back for a second term. And I say if I want to run for a second term, I'll run. So I'm saying they will prosecute you for this and all that. But whether they prosecute me or not, let's have people have a voice for Nigeria and defend the rights of the people of Nigeria. I'm aware that it comes with consequences. That is what is called militancy and vanguard. Not those who stay in Britain and wave placards. I've discussed power with you, and that's exactly what we've done with power. The president will commission only 100. But I've told you that it wasn't all the least fault. The fault was PSA couldn't discharge the power he was generating. He went into generation, not distribution. Distribution is in the hands of the federal government. So actually, he generated 150 megawatts. And I told you, PSA can only take 48. Now, out of the 130, PSA can only take 18. So it's not all the least. But he couldn't present it before the public properly. And they began to attack. Let me once more say to all of you, thank you very much. It's an opportunity and honor.